Francesco already mentioned it. He said when he started his class, he said, okay, either you keep your shoulders straight above your hips, which is probably the safest thing to do submission-wise, but if you mess up, a bit easier to get put out of balance. Whereas, what I'm gonna do, like the second thing Francesco said was put your weight, your shoulders, past the shoulder line. It's probably a bit more dangerous submission-wise. And well, you can also get swept, of course, but let's say each part has its benefits and its advantages. So I'm gonna start with something weird, let's say. Francesco, can you help me, please? Just to get the thing started. Could you please? Whatever. So, okay, the general approach for close guard, which is given many years, is always this. You get your both lapels together, you give it a twist, see? You make sure you keep your posture straight. You put your feet, toes on the mat, if you have flexible toes. I never had the superpower, so cannot do that. But you get connect the sleeve, okay? Then there is good and bad ways, but in some way or other, you stand up. Go completely straight, open that leg, see? Go backwards, go here, and then you start passing the guard. And nothing wrong with that, it definitely works. But the problem is, in close guard, what happens? You get your guard pulled down, so you gotta find a way back to get out of here. So, remember what I said yesterday, this is close, middle, and far. Close was safe. It's very hard for him to submit me here. But the moment I bring myself to the middle, that's when the hands come for the chokes, that's when the arm bars come, that's when the sweeps come, see? Because when I was at BJ Fanatics, I had the chance to see Alexander Ribeiro when he's filming his video. I was behind the camera, I checked the whole thing. And he always said, he's got like a very popular sweep from here, you remember? The one he always uses from here. Oh, the leg up, see? This sweep. And he said, it's always the moment the guy comes forward, or the guy goes backwards. So again, the middle is dangerous, right? So don't bring yourself to the middle by yourself. But in any case, if we got lucky, we found our way back, we got our grips, we finally maybe snapped the grip, I breaks it, have to get it again. Then the next thing, grab your own head please, with both hands, or maybe, okay, so now I need that sleeve. Okay, so then we have to learn to get up without that grip. So eventually we might get up, we get here, now we catch the collar. So it's a barrier, you can get underneath my leg. Ah, another barrier. Ah, but maybe also broke finally this grip here. Got my leg free, got up. Ah, now it's della riva. Really? Della riva? Ah, to deal with the della riva. Bring myself all the way back. And now to pass, I have to go all the way forward again. And as a competitor, what I was really tired of happening was I always did pressure passing. And I believe if I'm winning and I'm putting pressure, I should have the right to be not moving a bit and keep the pressure. Well, you're stalling, so I have to move and take my pressure away. And all he has to do is wriggle your butt left and right a bit, please. Now look how active he is. Look how active he is. And now, like if I'm stalling and I get penalties. And so, actually, winning is all the work, and now you're behind on points and you have to rush, and you cannot. So there's always a mode in the technique where everything is perfect. And if you wait, you will win. But you're not allowed to wait. You're not allowed to wait more than 29.59.999 seconds, because 30 seconds you get a penalty, so you cannot do that, right? So in any case, I think it's a bit silly in my head, not silly, but a lot of more work to go all the way back, open those legs, go all the way backwards, and then go all the way forwards again. So the idea came, let's stay inside, and let's go from there. Now I'm gonna show you something hidden a bit, look. And then we go from there, and just to pique some interest, look. A very, very common thing, that took a toddle off these battles, like pull the arm backwards and you're gonna pull the arm over this one, right? And they catch you. So the problem, look, when I'm here, for example, what would be my general, what would be the correct me if I'm wrong, but the general idea would be here to try to get your arm out. Yes or no? Mm-hmm. Yes, okay. But look what happens, I'm gonna get my arm out. You don't even have to attack me right now, okay? It's very hard to pull my arm out, it's stuck. And how will I get it out? Well, maybe I'll put my arm over here and I drag it out. But look what happens. Exactly, I expose myself here. Again, we can deal with this. It's not wrong by itself. It's a problem. So now, Francesco, you're going to let my arm come a little bit out. And now you go for the submission, please. And then it's the same as the Americana, armbar, kimura, all those things come. So what you can do actually is here. So I always use jiu-jitsu is if you want to have minimum effort, maximum efficiency, it's give the person what he wants until he does not want it anymore. So we're here, keep it tight please. So the submission comes when I go away.
And the sweep comes whenever I put myself out of balance. So the worst thing I could do from here would be pulling backwards and give him the Americano, unless we're slippery, then I get lucky. But it's something random that can always not count upon. Or if he would go underneath my leg here, please, go for it. See? And I put all my weight over here. Right? And another clue that already Francisco mentioned in his class, where the head goes, the body follows. Look, if Francisco starts to sweep me, I look to the ceiling, that's exactly what will happen. I will get swept. Go back, please. But go for it now again. Even if he's here and I look to the other side, sweep me now, please. It's quite hard for him to sweep me from there. But you have to put your nose on the mat, just like yesterday. So he goes underneath, see? And the first thing I never want to happen here is to go put my weight on that side, so I stay here. Now when he goes underneath the leg, and he goes, see, I'm gonna bring my weight over, and I'm gonna put, so, go back please. I want to get a really tight grip on this one over here. Get a super tight grip. The better you get it, the better for me. Okay, so he goes really tight, yeah? He goes underneath, see? And now again, like yesterday, the rock bottom, bring your elbow to your hip. Okay? You go over the head, and now Francesco will either tap or let go. You know why I tapped or no?
Wristlock.
The wrist lock there, yeah. And nobody will be. I never had anyone that stupid to tap for no competition. But they don't even get an advantage because the referees don't even see it. But they have to let go, and it's interesting. So he goes very deep with it. Great. I'm going to test a few things. He goes deep. I want you to feel what happens if you keep your weight here and put it backwards. Then he gets the sweep for free. I want you to feel also if you look at the ceiling, then you're already sweeping yourself. Yeah? Then I want you to feel the difference between looking over your other shoulder, and if you start to sweep, put your nose in the floor, and actually start walking north-south. Sweep me, please. It's harder. Arm bar me. It's also hard. Right? And then if I'm more patient, then I move first, then I get swept again. And then the last part you try, he goes over again. You get it super deep, super tight. He goes underneath, and you're going to go straight ahead. Put your weight at 12 o'clock, toes in the mat, put your elbow over, bring your, so I will not go hard, man, sorry. So bring your elbow back, and then push forward. And he's either gonna, well, give him the wrist lock, and the next part, you get your hand loose and you don't give the wrist lock. Everybody got this so far? Okay, try it, please. A mistake that often happens, that I see right now, and if you do it here, you probably do it in many positions. That is spreading yourself out. So now when you're here, I see some people doing this, leaning all the way forward. Right? Instead of going forward with your whole base. See, imagine you're doing a push-up. What is easier, to be here or to walk? So, for example, in general, lay down please. Imagine you're doing an over-under pass. And I'm putting myself like that. Well, he has more space, but I can cover it with my hands. But if Francesco now starts to walk backwards, there's no way for me to follow. Whereas if I keep myself tight and close, see, my feet, my toes on the mat, leaning forward, if Francesco walks away now, I can try to follow him. So when we're here, and he goes over the arm, see here, he gets the grip, see? And I'm not gonna go right away. If I go right away now, see, then Francesco will win, because now my back is exposed again. And if I wait here, so even give the leg a little bit, and he goes for it, go forward to catch, you stay in the middle, see? And I bring my legs close as well. And you start to, well, either arm lock or not. And I actually have an underhook at this moment. And the underhook we can really use, it becomes very valuable. Look, so once we're here, I want now to get swept a little bit. And then find the place where we will not get swept. So if he controls my arm here, see? I put myself, so that is sweeps, there's north, south, east, and west. And sweeps generally work in the in-between directions. So the southeast, southwest, northeast, northwest. Why? Because it has to do with how the head turns. And also, if I go to the east, I have my hand and my leg stopping me there. See? And the same on that side, here I have two hands and my head. And there I have my both feet. And usually, even if you sweep someone straight backwards, you have to deal with the whole sitting guard and the 50-50 and all those things. So usually, when you go in between directions, there is the hand and a bit of the head there. So in the diagonals, you only have to block one limb if you want to make a sweep there. And have the body weight distributed well. But go here, so you go for the grip. Goes for it too. And in the beginning, starts to go for the pendulum sweep. Put my arm over, so keep your hand deep in the beginning. See? Maybe you tap in, probably you won't, right? Now, I want to feel and sweep again. If I, wait one second, see? If I put my body weight, see, at the south, east, see, that's where the sweep should go. Right. If I put my weight at the northeast here, then it should roll me that side. It doesn't make sense to push me away this moment, see? Yeah. Here you're gonna roll me over your shoulder. If I put my weight here, see? Well, in theory, if I put my weight too much out, he can get his head out, but the sweep gets hard because I have my hand to post. And if I put my weight on that side, see? Here's where I can expect things like the hip bump sweep or maybe an arm bar, depending on where I keep myself. But you're gonna feel if you put your weight exactly in the middle, see? And now we rotate a bit, see, put his weight over his head. So try to feed me now, please, go for it. It's gonna be very hard. Then once I put my weight a bit backwards, it's when he can bump me and I have to restart tying the close guard. So once again, see? He goes under, so you get the good grip. Goes underneath, see? Bring my head over, bring my weight forward, squeeze to either get the tap or let him release his hand, and I keep your weight forward. And I feel the lower his hip is to the floor, the more I'm out of balance. So I'm always gonna rotate my hip towards his head and even put my knee on the floor if I like, or rotate through. See, the more I stack him, the more impossible the sweep gets. Even step over my head, please, and go for the, like you would do for an arm bar. See here, that's still not a problem because he has to extend this hip. See? And just like when today Christian taught his class, see, about it's not wrong to invert, but I think it's dangerous to push from there. See, push up, please.
No.
This is,
we can do it for many years until it's not okay anymore. It's as healthy as doing a squat like that. And for 10 years it will be okay, and then it hurts, and the doctor will say, hey, what are you doing for sport? Oh, I'll hit you, that's not healthy for your body, so don't do that. But just do it correct from the beginning, maybe. So don't push from stack positions. Okay. So try this, and let me continue from there, okay? Let's talk about the head. So very often, look, coming on top and and having a sweep is not something you should see as a black and white. It's not 100% sweep, 100% top. So what I want to say is this, look, if you're here, now I'm 100% on top, Francesca is 100% on bottom, right? And maybe gets my arms, okay, good. They put my weight slightly over here, and now I'm 90% on top, 10% on bottom. And we keep going, keep going, keep going. Now it's 50-50, see? And we keep going. And even here, it's still better I keep having this fight and just give up all the way. And go back. And if Francesco pushes through, see, I can lose here, we go to 0%, but I use the momentum to get 10% here back on that side. Got it? Okay, good. So, see, knowing this, usually, what is the very first thing that has to become on top? Imagine this, look, Francesco, do me a favor, okay? Keep your head on the mat here. You're not allowed to move your head and turn to your belly. But you're not allowed to move your head. So try to see how far you can take it. See? Here. That's where it stops. Just like Francesco said, this is the sweep, eh? Where the head goes, the body follows. If you try to do, so now try to do the scissor sweep again like before, without moving the head, see? Well, it works, eh? You know how it works? If I hang here like a pudding and he kicks, and even, see, then I fall myself. But you should not expect that to happen, see? So, but it also holds true for me, see? As long as I keep my head, so, he's on top when his nose hits the floor. So usually when I sweep, I teach, usually bring the head away, see? And put the nose on the floor, right? So it's a scissor sweep here. And I have two things I can do. I can look to the left, and I can look to the right. Which side should I look at to make the sweep more difficult?
Right.
To the right. Eh? So we're gonna do the wrong thing first. We're gonna look over our left shoulder first. Why does this make a difference? Because if I look left, then my shoulder starts to go, then my hip starts to go, and I will fall. Is it always a bad thing? No. It's always action reaction, jab and cross. But if you do boxing, you can open with a jab, you can open with a cross, but it's usually safer to open with a jab. So identify the safest thing. So the safest thing would be to be here and keep my body, my structure backwards, see, and keep my weight for myself. But I got, I managed to sweat me. Freeze, please. Look, that was the mirroring principle. So it's mirror here. If he moves his head away from the mirror, I'm gonna move my head away from the mirror. So keep sweeping, please. See. So it's not like I'm gonna go sweep me, please, sweep. That would be fun for once. Twice. So if he goes away, see, I'm gonna move my head away as well. See, keep sweeping me, please, go. And I post my head. Now, Francesco, see, try to sweep me very slowly. See? The more he moves his head away, see, I was just walking one line. Now look at my head. Well, but there's another thing you can do right now. So you can still push me over. I'm gonna bend my neck now.
And you're gonna put your hands on the floor, start walking backwards, and make me front roll to that side. And it's gonna succeed because I'm gonna give it, okay? So if I post my nose on the floor, great, see? Wait one second. If I bend my neck, you can start pushing me all over, and I will get swept. But, see, come again, please. Okay. If I start to sweep, see, and I look away, see, I can even lift my legs in here. Go, post my nose, keep going, please, Francesco. We cancel each other out here. You try to push me over now, it's gonna be hard. I can even, see, make it really funny, see, don't move now, please. You can even go for a headstand here, if you get better in these things. Francesco keeps pushing, see? I can walk away. If he puts his head to that side, the other side. We just make it, we made a 360, and we arrive here again. So again, try this slowly, so don't squash your head right away. And there's another thing to it, there is the other side. So if he sweeps, see, I go here, post my head. If Francesco gives up, his head comes back there. I can also return over here. Makes it easier if I have this grip, of course. So, but even Nogi, see, sweep as well. See, I can even have this, no arm at all, no grip. See? Even if I post my head here, see, keep going, please. You can already start preparing your turtle, see? And it looks like you're giving your back, but all I can suggest, look at bridge stuff also, so it leads to in early back defense as well, these things, okay? So try this, please, and let me go from there. It's another advantage I'm going to talk about having your nose on the mat is that you actually can, imagine the half guard. But it's the same thing from close guard, look. If I'm here, it's very hard to push him away. I can go close and push. What I should never do, see, is be here, well not never, but rarely do is push from here. Because just spread myself out. Maybe I push him over, you fall, boom, you push, okay, great. See? But before I can push again, I have to go close again before I can push. So whenever I push, I have to put my nose into the pool, go close, and I start driving. See, maybe it goes a bit backwards, see? And I keep following with my head. See? So the same thing would apply here if I have the scissor sweep. See, put your hand here. And let's say you fall, see, and he doesn't fall over, see here, boom. See, what I can do is start to come up and start driving my nose backwards. And keep the pressure. See, some of you, relax please, relax. Start to push like this. You spread yourself completely open, but if I keep driving my nose backwards, I can keep the pressure up. So it's not that, well, Francesco is canceling my motion out. And he can win, and I can still win. And to win, I need a mistake on his part. So for example, if I'm here, see? And Francesco decides to start looking up for some reason, see, then I can go and transition to something else. He's the first one who leaves his safe posture who will get swept. So I mean, just the same as I said in the beginning, do not start going forward without, this actually is, I call it pushing beyond advantage. It would be the same as if you're boxing, you give a cross like that, it's safe, and people throw a cross like that. If you hit, yes, it does not never. So that it never works, just more dangerous in case it doesn't. And it's the same thing over here. Because you cannot follow up with other attacks. You keep that in mind. Can you not, please? Now let's go back to the stacking glass, what I said, right? So, Francesco, what would be, so if you fight, right? Fight from a rock bottom, please. I believe in close guard bottom, there is two postures to start. If you're in the center, would be hip on the, if I'm leaning forward, keep your knees slightly over your hip, please. Okay, here, but keep the legs closed. Yeah. So look how this works. You're not gonna use your hands at all, okay? And I'm not gonna use my hands. And now pull your knees to your shoulders, please. Yeah. I'm gonna try to go up without using my hands. And it doesn't work. So if he relaxes his back, see, I can go up like that. So it's actually his hip that keeps my posture broken. Now why does he need his arms? Because I also have arms. So don't move your arms, please. Look, if I'm here, I can push myself up. But if he has his arms to the equation, so catch please, and I'll go rock bottom again. See, at the very least, and drag your knees forward. To your knees, at the very least, see, I have to take him with me right now. So arms fight arms, and hips fight hips. Understand? Go back down, please. And if I'm far away, that's what you also showed you guys, you put your hip up, and you connect. And the cool thing is, look, once someone is completely tied to my hip like that, if I put my weight a little bit forward, I'm already flying away, right? So between those two things, there is danger for me, right? Now, what often people do in close guard bottom, so I mean, let me be honest, look, Because my game is a bit of the opposite of what Francesco just showed. It depends on whose posture is right. Now, most people in close guard, and actually every guard completely, go up with your shoulders, please, put your head up. People are always too relaxed fighting like that and looking and having the moment like you said. Right? And they get away with it because these days you can open it up for forbidden. If you go back to a world where this is allowed, and people yank it too much, then it would be dangerous. Now, I always teach even my white belts can openers. Why? Because the dangerous stuff, I want to teach it properly and safe, better than it randomly happens. So put your head up, please. If you do a can opener and you start pulling, to relax, please. If I pull him this way, then, well, now you got safely the time to tap. If I yank it, it will be again okay for 10 years and then it's not okay anymore. Now, so we have to protect each other. So if I yank, dangerous for him. If I have you here and now don't lose your neck, but just push away with your hip, dangerous for him. Now I do this and he pushes at the same time. We both ruin each other. Got it? So how do you get safely when someone controls your neck? You should actually push your head into the air, see? And put your hip on the bottom and now it's way more dangerous. And now you can start walking away, see? So this is actually one of my first videos I teach at my white belt, see, how to protect the neck. Because you can break your elbow, it's not fun, you can break a lot of things, but do not break your spine, because where it breaks, that's where you're gonna live the rest of your life, depending on how it gets, okay? But luckily for us, many people still make this mistake to keep the head up. In IBJJF, we're not allowed to do this. So play with it, it's easier. And then don't do it anymore, but still occasionally do it, because there's MMA people also, who, like if you, especially if you go to open mats, and there's people with MMA, expect them to do those can openers. And oh, it's not allowed. Yeah, okay, it doesn't really look very comfortable. We should be able to deal with those things. But to make it legal, what you can do, see, remember the first thing, we give the arm, right? If someone puts his head up, and even on black belt matches, I do this, if they're here, I already know, have a clue that they're not very worried about posture. So they put their head up, you just go in right away, put around the head, and start walking forward. Now look, if I spread myself too thin, here lift my legs backwards, you can either go for the butterfly, or, go back in please, start walking away on your shoulders. And then he can put his foot on my hip, and he isolates my arm, and then it's when it gets still hard, but it gets dangerous. So what I want to do, see, I want to put my elbows to my knees, knees to my elbows. At this point, even if, see, keep your neck straight, see, and he relaxes his hip, or push me away, please. The moment he pushes me away, see, it actually bends his spine, and I can go forward. I want you now to have a small battle here. Keep your weight at 12 o'clock. Try to walk away, Francesco, please. Should be hard. If he walks, I can follow. If I put my weight backwards, walk backwards, that's when I start to lose a position. But if you're stronger, you can still compensate a lot over there. So, I mean, a lot of has to go wrong before I get tapped from here if I know what I'm doing. So again, I catch, see here, go pull his shoulder backwards, connect yourself, make yourself tight, walk forward, and can even go as far as putting your nose on the floor. And then maybe a little bit back. And I try to fight, go. Yes, so north-south, it's very hard for him to move. What he still can do, is grab underneath my leg. When he rotates, he brings his head to that side, I'm gonna mirror him. I'm gonna walk my head away and walk my hip towards his head. So don't move yet, because if you switch, I have to switch. Yep. That was a good job you did. Here, so fight again, please, go. Great. See, the moment Francesco gets his head back in the middle, see, I have to go back here as well. And later the point is to keep him there. So once again, his head is up, I go in, pull back, knees on the floor, go forward, roast him a bit here, walk away please. Should be hard, I keep following, great. Go underneath your arm, the moment he goes, see, I'm going to use my right knee and put it as if I go to side control and give him a push here. And now wait from here, and now he can go put pressure on his head. Even if he gets back out over here, there's a moment you can release your arm. You can still do all the things you did before. So even if you don't like the stack passing game, right? What it's still very useful for is this. All those times when you want to have your posture back, you want to fight close, let's go close. He starts to push you away, and you can use it to recover your posture and still fight the basic thing. They work together in action reaction, okay? Play with this position, please. And if you don't get it, if you don't feel it, call me and I will help you out. If I ask around to everybody, what is the most horrible position to be in? What will you say?
Stack.
Sorry?
Stack.
A stack. And you can also say submissions, but there's a difference. Because imagine you're a white belt and coming to the gym. And I've been guilty of this in the past as well, less these days. And you get put into a lock
and you tap, and everybody accepts the tap. Good. But then you stack someone, and they, stop, stop. No, you're not supposed to tap, it's not a submission. Keep fighting, okay, you keep suffering there, right? Yeah, but it happens. I've been guilty of this in the past. Well, don't be weak, but then again, you start to think, maybe this person has a point, you know? So, in any case, there is rarely a position where that's as comfortable as a stack. And if you do competition, and you come to a position like that, this is the biggest thing I hate. You put, okay, put your legs wide, please. I really have matches, I don't know. Put like the...
You might ask too much.
Imagine you're super flexible and stalled in the mat. I really had matches. Where I was in this position, the whole match gets stalled. Look, this, imagine his feet are on the floor. This is not a guard. This is the illusion of a guard. In MMA, you get smashed. In every fighting sport, nobody would consider it a good position. But I really hate like the arrogance. And I hear people like, oh, come on, pass. and yeah, I don't know. I don't know. And the whole point is, once you have someone perfectly stacked, there is no way you should move. Because if you move, he's out of balance. It's always about trapping the head. Look, if I'm here, and Francisco moves his head a bit sideways, see? I can keep him stacked by moving that way. He goes the other side, I can go as well. Stay in the middle. But if I go first, that's it, and he can do this one, or the other side also works. Yeah, and that's when I lose the stack. So there's like an end to it. And in theory, what I should do, I want to be flexible, let's stay there until they're very uncomfortable. And it's in competition, it's only 30 seconds you get to do that, right? So that problem I start to solve with the class from tomorrow, the triangle path, I will talk more about that later. But in any case, look, if you stack someone, okay? So even if the legs are closed, for example, look here. So let me go north-south, okay? So if you're here and you start to walk away, don't move please, don't move, just stay here. And I bring your back butt backwards. Try not to move your head too soon. I will go very slow. Look, but this always happens. If I start to drag, then start to move your head sideways eventually. Unless you're those very flexible freaks, we don't do that. But even there, they don't really have offense. It's very hard to push away when in the center. You also have to choose a side. And we're actually playing with that. So what I'm doing now from close guard, this is my whole game, trying to go from everywhere to the north-south stack. I had one time at Michael Lange in my gym for 1 week, one of the best people in the world, and there's one guy with a very flexible guard. And what I noticed, everybody had a problem passing that guy's guard. It's at least 7 years ago, I think. And Michael Lange passed him every single time, but always went for the north-south stack. So this is, there are people who are good there, but it's very hard these days to find someone who specializes in you can invert. But rarely will you have someone who chooses to invert right away, unless there are those people, but it's less common. So actually, we bait him until he goes for the stack. Now, so let's say we're here, we control the head, and I go over, and I stay in the middle. Look, Francisco, stay here, okay? If he doesn't want to move, I can make it worse for him by rolling my shoulder in, basically like a full flute choke. So try to reach for my with your left arm for my right leg, please. That's hard, right?
Yep.
So the odds are he's gonna go for my other leg. See, he goes. Go, go, go. See, freeze. I can help him with my knee and push him more sideways. Now, as long as I'm here, Francesco can reasonably use his hand to push my face. On the other side, on the side, please. Push my face away and instead of getting his head out. Every time this happens, you return to the center. So the whole idea of how I pass always where the head goes, I rotate my hip towards that side. Imagine he's got an arm bar, for example. Go for arm bar. See? Here I can get arm bar, but the moment I put my weight over and start to go north-south, you can put my weight backwards. He cannot finish the arm bar as long as his head is in the middle. If his head starts to go out, then we can still deal with that as well, go back. When it gets more dangerous. And if I put my weight this side, it's when he can extend his hip again. But in the middle, my weight at 12 o'clock or north, how you define it. So you do the arm bar, please. He's gonna be, from the center. So he tried to do it. It's very hard. So if we keep him there and he chooses the side first, we can bait that for our pass or for taking advantage of the situation. So we go over, went forward, he catches my leg, see, he goes for it, great. The more he goes, the better, see. If he really commits to it, raise your hip up, see, and put your, really go for the pendulum, see, that makes it even easier, the more they commit for it. So once I'm here, I choose to put my arm out, see, and go over the head. Why do I do this? Because now it's very hard for him to put his head on this side, and the other side is stuck with my knee. And here, keep your weight forward, and stay here for a bit. Now,
I could talk an hour about how put your position correctly. Basically, be tight, see? Look to the floor. Whenever it pushes me away, see, look to that side. Starts to push me there, I look away to that side. And just spend a lot of time there, get swept a bit. And we do position rolling, don't be like this. Okay, we're here now, sweep me, bum, sweep me hard. Ah, I lost note. So, you have mini battles, you're here. Okay, put me out of balance a bit. Okay, you got me, let's go back. Bring me out of balance now. Okay, great. Put my weight too much backwards, put your head up. Yeah. Let's go again. And my goal is here to steam him in the middle, see? And let them get out and gradually make it worse. He might be up. If his head goes there, that's where his escape is. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put my weight here. Put your head here now, that gets hard. So when he goes to the other side, and he pushes himself through, the electronic can start going north-south. Block the head, start passing from this side. Well, I can control it better. So we'll go over that detail in the last segment. Everybody got it, or need to repeat it?
Sorry? Show again.
Show again, okay. So can you please?
What did I do to you? Who said it? Who said it?
I did it again.
Because you don't drink cappuccino, man. Come here. So I go forward. Keep my pressure here. It goes. I start going to. I consider it already a side control, just between his legs. Get your arm out. Block the head. Here I'm in danger to bring my weight backwards. Great. See? Sometimes he even can completely lay down. But go here. See? So I get my arm out. He starts to rotate, so you have to control the arm, start passing here. And here, don't rush. The moment I push, he put me out of balance again. If he wants to have his head up, so whenever I have someone in the stack, I keep him there for at least 29.59 seconds. And when the referee looks his watch, that's when you start, well, your coach should tell you that, and then you start to move again. Okay? Let's try. Are there any questions about this? No questions. Okay? So look, you can use this for way more things. For example, what I was today playing with today, for example, was the 50-50. This is more advanced, but look, it's always about the head. Whenever I can control the head, and I leave myself here, then he can just rock bottom and I will lose it. Whenever he bends in, I can...
Is it actually allowed to bend in, Jeff? Is it here?
Yeah.
It's allowed, right? It's still a camera. But it's how can I say, the same thing for close guard, only here it's allowed. But if you have any, put your weight over, see here. So you try to fight now. Well, you can sweep me if I put my weight too much over here. And then I will fall again. If I keep my weight to the exact side that he cannot go, so try to fight, go. It's very hard. And what are his options right now? Invert more, please. No, so put your head more closer to me. Here. And I can go that side as well. And keep him trapped here. And to be honest, often I don't really have a real pathway to go to yet. That's just something that happens after a while. But to keep the pressure, see? Maybe he feels it too much. Starts opening this leg, see? Give this leg away. For example, put your leg more here. Okay, I want to sweep you. Okay, good. Good grab, see? And he can, well, wait one second, see? He starts solving the problems here. And also, you know what is going to be his escape. So when you stay here and he starts to go to the other side, see? So put your head on the other side. Okay. That's when you start, you can relax a little bit. Gradually you can start going, see, from here, to knee bars as well. And the thing is just play with it. If you are in a butterfly, it's actually the natural counter to this. Well, my guys, the heavy guys try to stack me, I go from close guard to butterfly. So if I'm here, see, but even look, relax please, relax. If I get here, I'm still winning the fight. I keep his head bent, see? One thing also, if he starts to push me up, see, as long as I keep my weight forward, that's actually safe. Put my weight to one side, that's when it starts to go down again. So again, if he sweeps me back, slowly please, sweep me to, sweep me to, slowly to this side. Freeze, where should I look, this side or this side? Are you sure? If I go this side, exactly left side, see, I have to go look here and make my opposite hip heavy. He switches to the other side. You can do the same thing again. So always switch, well, you look away where he's looking at, see? Are other examples? Something you can experiment with. And this is something I would not maybe recommend in matches going good, but I like to do it on seminars. I like to tap people with things that don't work. Because if you can make those work, then that's cool, see? So for example, never submit someone from close guard. Well, if I put my arm here and I stay here, it's very dangerous. But if I get the cross grip and put my weight over, it's not so dangerous anymore. See, and now they start, imagine this, they start to rotate, they can start going for these chokes as well. Again, will it work? It will depend me putting my weight correct. But I've stepped many people here, and even heavier people. Will you get good people with this? Well, you will get good people with this if they're in a rush, because the riding would bring his head away, and again, if to bail out, you need to bring your posture up again. Now, one big reason why I do recommend to do this sometimes is because you get immediate feedback when something is wrong. It's, look, against the person who doesn't know a lot, and you're in mount doing the choke, or let's say on bottom, it's hard to realize what your mistake was. But here, since my arms, should I wrote it in, please? See, since my arms are out of the equation, see, it's at this point, if my choke is there, see, it's all about where I put my weight. And for passing the guard, and on bottom to be aware about it for sweeps, it's all about how you distribute your weight. So for me, it's always the same. Put your weight slightly over at 12 o'clock. Aim for the stack, see? And then even if he starts to get his head out, see? Go out, head out. It's still costing more energy to go there. So do I recommend to go straight away for here? No. But maybe you're up front, he goes in, see? And I can pin him here. Keep your weight forward. He goes, see? And use the exact same thing to pass on this side. Another one, and this leads into back defense a bit. Ah, by the way, this works with a gi as well, but then you need more of the head grip. It's safer to practice with the gi at first. So imagine that you start dragging your arm to one side, right? Instead of always fighting back, what I like to do sometimes, and on matches where I was really losing on points, I had to go a bit faster, then I actually gave it. So you get the cross grip, put your elbow here, and I start walking sideways. And see, now I'm trying to take my back here, please. Go. It's not evident, right? It can backfire, but it's not that easy. And often when it happens, go back down, please. Often what happens if you get this grip and you wait, see? You start going to your back. See? The moment that he's actually doing the right thing, see? And I can cancel it out, but what often will happen, go back, please. If they bring their hip up first, which is a very wrong thing, so go inside your head and start going up with your hip. See? So go to my back with your hip. Go over me. Take my back, go for my back, go for it. See? Go. And if you can capture the head, see? And again, break this and start going for the stack in this way. And then it's always here that you seam a bit and get out. The only downside, it's a slow game, and if you do it fast and the guy is good, it will backfire. Last part, close guard. You can always play this, even if his head is straight. You can even play it from middle distance, see? Whenever he pushes his hip up, that's when the stack is there. Then put your weight slightly over. You can even play it from here. See? And I try to move. You wait here. The solution on this part is actually, so if he walks away, he can do it if my weight is backwards. If I go first to one side, now you go with your head, then I'm in the downside. But if I wait exactly in the middle, I wait here and he goes to one side, okay, I rotate that side. The moment he catches with his arm, yeah, that's when he committed. See, now I can actually block him to that side and steamroll him to that side. Now, what is the solution for him? Or an extra motion you can put into him? He cannot go north, he cannot go east, he cannot go west. Where should he go? Sorry?
South.
He can go south. But, so if I'm here, he puts his both hands underneath, yeah, and start walking deeper. That's another element we can put into it, but even in this case, if I keep going forward, see, keep going forward, eventually, keep going backwards, please, straight backwards, and put your hip on the floor, rock bottom, head up. There's still a dead end to this. And even here, look, but again, if I roll up my hip first and I bring this head out, I'm back in the downside. But something fun to play with is this, go straight forward, see, and you go for feet here. So going for foot locks. And then when he brings his head out to one side, see, that's when you go, so bring your head out, see? I can start attacking the legs here. And again, most often, it will often, if the guy is strong and explosive, result in a scramble where he starts to push you away and he opens his legs. And that's where actually maybe one in the first place. So that's the whole thing about it, okay?